Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO, DPC Technology. We've got a really cool one today. Today we're going to test the new Enterprise Network Video Recorder, or the ENVR. So today's not going to be a full deep dive review. Today's just going to be an unboxing. I'm going to get it set up on the network. I'm going to go through my initial first impressions and how we're going to use it here in the office. This is going to be a part of a bigger series we're going to do here about all of the enterprise-grade equipment that Unifi is coming out with. I'm super excited about this. So part of that is we're going to review kind of the whole ecosystem as well as doing a deeper dive into each unit. So with that, let's jump right into the specs of this new unit. We'll get it unboxed with Sean and we'll go through the basics. So first off, this is a 16 bay unit. It's got 5 fans on the back of it and 1 fan on each of the power supplies. Now Unifi was nice enough to send this unit out to me for free for testing, and I only have 1 power supply in my unit, but the retail version will ship with 2 power supplies. On the back, you're also going to notice you have your connectivity. It's got 1 10 gigabit Ethernet connection that can also do 1 2.5 and 5 gigabit Ethernet. It also has 2 SPF Plus ports that can do either 1 gigabit or 10 gigabit Ethernet on each of those 2 ports. So plenty of connectivity, and it's all on the back, which is nice because it kind of keeps it hidden away and neat looking. On the front of the unit, you have 2 really nice billet handles with little triggers in them to release the unit from the rack. So obviously with 16 drives in this unit, it's going to be quite hefty. So it comes with rack rails to mount it to a 4-post rack. Those are included in the box, as well as all the other mounting hardware. Also on the front, besides the obvious 16 bays, you have a notification LED. You also have your reset button, and you've got your interface for the ENVR bezel, which is an optional add-on. Although I don't have the optional ENVR bezel at this point, I am going to get that in the future. So check back for my deep dive review while I'll go into the functionality of that bezel. This isn't a silent unit. It's not something you would want to have in your living room. Although it's not oppressively loud, it will probably be one of the quieter things in your rack. But if you're used to a completely silent system, there will be some noise associated with a chassis of this size. I'll quickly throw a microphone on the back of the system to give you an idea of the sound, although I'm not sure how well that'll translate on YouTube.
This is the sound of a ENVR.
But take my word for it, it is noticeable, but it is not loud. So with that, now that we have this thing powered on and connected to the network, let's jump into the app and adopt the unit. Then we'll jump into the software on my computer and we'll configure the device.
All right, so it automatically found the ENVR. I'm gonna go ahead and click setup. I'm actually standing right next to the device. It's finding it, it's doing its thing. I'm gonna give it a new name and I'm gonna go, let them have analytics improvements. It's going to see all my hard drives here. They all look healthy. They're all 18 terabytes. I'm going to go ahead and click next. I'm going to go storage protection basic, 252 terabytes, storage protection to 36 terabytes, 2 drives. And I'm not going to go with a hot spare. So I'm going to go next. And it's going to go ahead and click setting up. And it's going to go ahead and go through, prepare the drives. It's going to take about 5 minutes. We'll hold here and go through this process together. I will say I like the timer counting down in 5-second increments. It gives you confidence that you're not stuck in a boot loop or something crazy. So that's a nice added feature there. All right, now it's just finishing up. Okay, so that was it. And you can go to the Protect app now and look at it. I'm gonna jump over to the computer and let's log in and check out what's going on.
All right, so that process of adoption was super easy on the phone. I'm gonna jump into my desktop because it's easier to show you guys the rest of the setup from there. So anyways, I've logged in real quick into my dashboard here on the ENVR. It popped up, there's no devices. So I'm gonna walk you through it real quickly. I'm gonna go into settings real quickly. And obviously it's gonna look very, very similar to what you're used to and everything else in Protect. I'm gonna go into Control Plane real quick and I'm gonna go ahead and update, proceed with that. I'm gonna install Access and I'm gonna install Interspace. Like I said before, these are the 3 applications that run on this. I'm actually gonna migrate my Access install over to this as well. It is currently on my Cloud Key, and so I'm gonna migrate that over as part of this upgrade. And I'm gonna install that, and I'll let that happen in the background. You can see here, obviously, you got backups. I set that to auto backup weekly. We've got storage where we can see. So obviously, I set that up with two parity drives there. So I'm totaling here 252 terabytes, you know, with 288 raw terabytes. I think 252 terabytes is, obviously, that's going to be more than enough for me. And if I wanted to reformat or anything, I can come back in here and do it. Obviously, I can go into each one of these drives and get the details off the drives, all that kind of stuff, which is kind of nice to have. In console here, we also have, you know, the basic setups, just like we would on any other console. I can transfer ownership, do a factory reset, learn more about this console, etc. All, you know, important stuff to set up, but I'm not going to go too deep into all that as this is just kind of an overview. Obviously, same thing with your push notifications. So under admin and users, obviously there's something here important for me. Part of this journey that we're taking on this enterprise review is I'm going to adopt everything into UID Enterprise. So I'm going to add this to my existing UID workspace. So basically, it's going to ask me to generate a token. I'm over here in UID Enterprise. I'm going to go in here and I'm click Add a Console. I'm going to give this token description. And I'm going to say it doesn't expire. I'm going to go create. It's going to ask me to verify that on my cell phone. All right, now that I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and copy that. And I'm going to paste it over into Add to Existing Workspace. Boom, paste. And what this is going to do for me is now I can just manage this device. It's going to let me choose DPC technology. And now what this is going to do for me, and that's going to let me add this to my UID workspace, which is awesome for me because then when I'm over in UID, it's just going to show up as one of my other devices. I can add users and manage it through the UID Enterprise workspace, which is awesome for me. And you can see real quickly, boom, it's over here and it's on and it's ready to go. I am then going to go back in Control Plane and make sure I am up to date. I'm going to set up access here just in the background. And I'm going to go into, I'm going to get out of access. I'm going to go back into Protect here. And I am going to start adopting some of these devices. My NVR Pro is still on the network here. I'm still have most of my cameras on this. I went through and I kicked out a few of the cameras to adopt over here. So basically you go into manage on the camera and you go remove and then it's available for the next unit. So I need to do that for the rest of them. But for now, I'm just going to adopt these guys as part of my demo. It also, you could see it was putting that up there. I'm going to enable smart detection. I could have just added them from up there, but walk you through a real world use case. And it's saying there, oh, wow, just fired right on. Man, wow, that's incredible. So yeah, they're right up in there. Now, obviously I will design my workspaces and all that stuff. And also these cameras were all on the latest firmware and everything. So there wasn't much of an upgrade that they had to do. They may pop on and do one more update if this new ENVR's firmware is newer than my UNVR Pro was. But anyway, so you got the same interface that you're used to seeing in your Protect here. I've got five cameras. Obviously, I've got a ton of room on this, so it's not going to be stressed at all for quite some time. So you can also add your archiving, how you can download it. You can add an account. I don't have my UNAS Pro here locally. I want to check that out, and I may do that in my deeper dive with that being locally and seeing how that works to back up to my UNAS Pro. So stay tuned for that video if that's something you're interested in. So that's it for the main stuff. I'm going to go through a couple questions here, but obviously, you know, with 252 terabytes and I'm using 7 gigabytes of 252 terabytes, I need to put this thing through its paces a little bit, put a bunch of cameras on it, play with it, scrub it, see its detection, see, you know, how it's working. So, you know, is this machine going to be worth $1,999 over what we're paying for our UNVR Pros, which we, you know, like and love? I don't know. Obviously, you're talking about the NVR Pro with 4 gigabytes of RAM. This has got 32 gigabytes of RAM. This has got an 8-core processor in it. It's got 24 gigabytes of onboard storage. It's got all these bays in this array. It's got all the makings of, you know, being able to really kick butt and take names. But the only way to know that it's worth the price premium over stacking 2 NVRs, obviously it's double the price there. It's got the capability of doing twice as many 2K cameras and almost twice as many 4K cameras. So for the right instance, I'm thinking that it's probably going to be a yes, that is worth the upgrade. I don't think I'll ever get to 74K cameras in this location, but I can get pretty dang close. A couple things I want to go over. A, the bezel isn't shipping yet, so I definitely want to do a deeper dive and review into that. But I'm really stoked to run with this device for a while, see what kind of storage timeframes we're getting. But I really want to thank Unifi for sending me the ENVR. And if you're interested in more of this enterprise level stuff, please like and subscribe. I've got a lot of good content coming in the future. If you have any questions or comments or anything you want me to test in my deep dive of the ENVR, please put them down below. I read them all and I'll make sure that they get into the next video. Otherwise, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.